Coach Lauren here, and I am super excited to introduce a brand new segment to you called Local Leaders. In these socially distant times when we're all at home and we're all separate from our San Bruno community, it can be really hard to feel engaged, to feel inspired. And so my goal for this season is to provide you with a bunch of cool role models in our San Bruno community that'll teach you lessons about leadership, athleticism, staying healthy, anti-bullying, confidence, integrity, and teamwork, in addition to the really fun lessons that we have each week. So super excited to get going on this segment with you all. Our first interview for this video is San Bruno City Council member Linda Mason. Linda Mason is San Bruno's newest city council member. She is the mother of two young boys, ages 7 and 4, and the wife of Andrew Mason. Andrew and Linda moved to San Bruno when she was pregnant with their first son in 2012 and fell in love with the community here. In her day job, Linda is an attorney for a local government agency working on redevelopment, policy, and subsidy administration for over 14,000 low-income households. Her only wish is for more time in the day. So hopefully, Junior Giants, you'll learn a little bit more about leadership and confidence from one of San Bruno's most positive and impactful leaders. Impactful means that she's making a big, great change in our community. And I hope that you enjoy our first segment of Local Leaders. Woohoo! Let's get into it. And then we'll just jump in with our first question. So, number one, with our segment on leadership and confidence, our first question is, how would you explain leadership and confidence to our players?
So I think that leadership is really about how you can drive a path forward for others to follow. And leadership is best utilized when you're driving that path forward in a positive manner. And so it's also important to note that a true leader is able to also admit when they're wrong. And step back and allow themselves that vulnerability to say, I was wrong, and this is what we should do, or this is how, you know, we can get past this. As far as confidence goes, confidence is really about you, right? It's about your faith in yourself. It's about your faith in your abilities. And I think that confidence really comes from within. And sports is one of the best ways that I've seen. I was just saying to Lauren before the interview started that I wasn't very active in sports growing up. When I was in college, I did 2 years of capoeira, and I think that's probably the most active that I have been. But I love the camaraderie around it. I love the energy that you have after you exercise. And I think that all of those things really help to build your self-esteem and your confidence. So that's how I would look at leadership and confidence.
That's awesome. Well, thank you so much for those really comprehensive definitions for all of our players. I really appreciate it. And I learned so much just from that first question. So to follow up on that, I'm wondering, you know, when you talk about confidence, how did you find the confidence to run for a position on San Bruno City Council?
Yeah, so I was already the chair of the Planning Commission at the time. I had been appointed to that seat about a year before. And I saw the number of changes that were coming to San Bruno. During my regular day job, I work in a local government agency. I feel strongly that if you want to make change, you make change from within. And I felt like it was an opportunity to bring the skills that I'd learned at my job to the city where I live and my own community. And so I was actually approached by a number of residents who had seen me on the Channel 1, you know, Planning Commission is still on Channel 1 live. And I had been approached by residents who I had never met before and asked me if I'd be interested in running for city council. And I essentially said, I hadn't thought about it at this time. You know, I still do have two young kids and a pretty demanding career. But, you know, the faith in me was quite inspiring. And I said, as long as the people who have approached me are willing to walk with me and truly do the legwork to help me get elected, then I'm all in. And so if you're all in, then I'm all in. And so it was really nice to have the faith of others. And I think that really helped build my confidence to think this was a real possibility. And here I am.
And that's great to hear, you know, when you talk about the support of our San Bruno community and really, you know, pushing you to run for this position, what I hear and what I hope our players at home are hearing is that, you know, confidence is it's within yourself, but then it's also about the people that you surround yourself with. And if you surround yourself with people who believe in you, then that can empower you and push you to do great things.
So. Oh, it's such a big deal to not just the people who supported, but the people you met going door to door who kind of jumped in. And I think I felt like it was a real mind shift for a lot of people to say, look at all this that's coming to San Bruno and we want to be part of it. We all want to be part of it. And, mm-hmm. and I think it was really, I mean, I was excited. There were days where I felt like I wasn't the candidate. I just was going door to door and, you know, it ended up actually being really fun. But I think a lot of that confidence, to your point, came from support from so many of our San Bruno residents that I could not have done any of this without them. And I couldn't be here without them. So yeah. Thank you.
Well, San Bruno is such a beautiful community, so that's awesome to hear.
Oh, yeah, definitely.
So going, I guess, this is definitely related to, you know, your run and your election as well, but in what you mentioned earlier, but can you, you know, describe a time that you were unsure of your ability to achieve one of your goals, but your confidence in yourself enabled you to persevere? And this can be related to the election, but also in, you know, any instance in your life as well.
Yeah, I think most recently it would be fair to say that it was the election. I mean, I look at campaigns that have been run. I had been selected for a group the year before called New Leaders Council, which is a group that has really taken off nationally. But it's little groups of individuals who are selected. There's an entire application period. And they're from all different walks of life. And what I really liked about the group was that it wasn't just maybe people who wanted to be politicians or just wanted to be lawyers, but I was sitting literally next to a vice president of a bank. I was sitting next to an ethics analyst for Google. I was sitting next to an analyst who was an attorney, but working as an analyst for Facebook. And the idea was to bring all of these different sectors of society together to say, how can we all make change where we are? And so I think that going from that launching pad to think to myself, how can I really make a change being a mother of now I have a 4 and a 7-year-old and then have a career and then be a wife. And that is just a reality that I think a lot of people don't realize how complicated it is to balance all of these different demanding aspects of your life. But I also thought that I looked around and you see females in politics and you see females who are in these high ranking positions. And I'm sorry, but a lot of them don't have kids and we need moms running, you know, and I am really lucky that my parents live very close by, and absent COVID-19 happening where you have to separate yourself from everybody, they have just been our rock in the sense of our backup daycare if there's an emergency meeting or, you know, they really bought into the idea of me running. And they were there to support both Andrew and I with both of our extracurricular activities, I would call them, because it's a lot of meetings. It's not just our standard San Bruno City Council meetings. And Andrew's on the school board, as I think most of San Bruno knows. So it was hard. I mean, I'm not going to lie. I think it was really hard, and it was a gamble whether we were going to, you know, be able to maintain the balance. But I think that the confidence really, like I said before, came from the support that we received, not just from each other, but from the community. And I didn't know if I was going to win. I can tell you the night of the election, I didn't want to go to the election party. And I had planned on just staying home. And I remember my parents said, you've got to come over here. There's all these people who walked for you and they're waiting for you. And I had literally walked in the door when the first results came out, and it was, you would have thought it was New Year's Eve in New York, because it was in San Bruno, this house filled with people just cheering. And so I would say that recently that was the biggest, I think that was really the biggest achievement. So yeah, thank you for asking.
Of course, yeah, I'm getting goosebumps when you're telling of the election night. Like, I'm like, wow, you know, I can't even imagine you walk into this room with your supporters and you just feel so embraced by our community. I think that's amazing to hear. So
it was, yeah, you know, it was really beautiful. And I felt so lucky to be part of the community.
Wow. Okay. Well, that's Fantastic. And, you know, along those lines of leadership, of, you know, people in our community, maybe you can even name some people in our community, you know, who are some of the greatest leadership role models that you look up to? And then who would you recommend that our players look up to, you know, as they're going through growing up and being kids, you know, who are strong role models that they can latch on to?
Yeah, I think in the community, I would say that, you know, we have a lot of people who give back in San Bruno. Mm-hmm. I think a lot more than people think that give credit, you know, that to give credit. I don't know if people know, but the majority of our senior center, which is one of the best in San Mateo County, which is made up of 20 cities, mm-hmm. Is run practically entirely by volunteers. And so every single volunteer who shows up every day to the senior center is giving back, and I think is a leader in the community, because our seniors wouldn't have that social life really without those volunteers. I think the people who give back at the Catholic Worker House on 2nd Avenue, it's the only shelter that we have in San Bruno. It is kept immaculate in the community, and they give food to the homeless. They have, I believe, 9 or 10 shelter beds. And most people don't even know that it is a shelter, and it's right in the middle of, like I said, our community here in San Bruno, and they give back so much. We have our St. Bruno's church that gives away food. We have St. Robert's with Sister Cheryl, who has done a phenomenal job in giving back and leading the way for St. Robert's in San Bruno. So I think that we actually have a lot of leaders here in the community that are either not spoken of, or people just know because San Bruno is really a small community. I think internationally, I would look at people who have used their fame to give back. So a local hero, I think, is Tom Brady. Tom Brady is somebody who, you know, not only does he give back his own money, but he actually uses his status to host fundraisers where they've raised up to $100 million. You know, name matters. So if any of our San Bruno, you know, junior giants ever become famous, remember that San Bruno wants a new library. And, you know, those are the kinds of help that we really need. And the other one, I think, in just talking to Lauren prior to this interview that I wanted to mention, because I'd been reading quite a bit about him, but this is a Senegalese soccer player. And I'm not sure if people have heard of him, but his name is Sadio Mané. And he is this amazing soccer player who plays for Liverpool. And the reason that he caught my eye was because he has really come up not just as a phenomenal professional athlete, but because instead of buying new houses and buying new phones and buying new cars, he's actually given back to the community. And so one of the things he said, if you don't mind, Lauren, I actually wrote down this quote because I thought it was so touching, is he was asked why he gives his money away instead of buying things for himself. And he says, "Why would I want 10 Ferraris, 20 diamond watches, or 2 planes? What will these objects do for me and for the world? I was hungry. I had to work in the fields. I survived hard times. I played football barefooted. I did not have an education and many other things. But today, with what I earn thanks to football, I can help my people," he explained. "I built schools, a stadium, clothes, shoes, food for the people who are in extreme poverty. In addition, I give 70 euros per month to all people in a very poor region of Senegal, which contributes to their family economy. I do not need to display luxury cars, luxury homes, trips, and even planes. I prefer that my people receive a little of what life has given me." And I think on an international and a local level, that is real leadership.
That's incredible. Oh my gosh. It's so, you know, especially in these times, it's so refreshing and it's so comforting to hear, you know, really prominent leaders express those emotions, you know, that want to give back to their communities, their want to pay it forward and to make sure that those that come after them, you know, are in better situations than they, you know, had growing up. So I think that's an incredible message. And I'm really glad that you shared that on this interview, because now all of our players at home will hear that as well. So.
Oh yeah. And you should Google him. He's pretty amazing.
Yeah. Yes. Oh, like put his picture, you know, my role model now, you know?
And for those of you who don't know, cause I think the age group is 5 to 18, football is soccer in other, you know, here in the US. So just FYI.
Yeah. Thank you. But yeah. So, I mean, going forward from, you know, role models that our players can look up to? And, you know, we've talked about different traits that our players can have. You know, how do you recommend that our players, you know, eventually become leaders in our community? And then how can they even grow some of these skills right now while we're all at home and while we might have some more time to do that?
Yeah, I think now, you know, I'll just say based on my experience, but I think the suggestions that I would make to our players is, you're a leader in your home, right? Everything you do every day is leading, especially if you have siblings. And so if mom and dad are home and they're not working, now's probably not a great time to ask for anything to be purchased or bought, right? If your siblings are bored, now's a great time to say, hey, let's play a game. Let's make a game. Let's create a game, you know? But I think that the leadership in your home is really about creating your cohesive environment with your family. You will not have this time again. We will not have this time again. So at this time, I think that we need to be vulnerable with each other. We need to say, this is what we would like to accomplish, definitely as adults. And I think as a family unit, while we're home, let's really appreciate each other, because I think that you create great leaders in the home. And then you hope that those aspects and those values are then passed on outside the home when this COVID-19 situation is over.
Oh, yeah, and that's really great advice. Even for myself, you know, thinking right now, I really appreciate hearing your perspective about how leadership starts in the home. Because, you know, so often I feel like we're told, you know, leadership starts in the power of your voice, or maybe the amount of people that you can kind of control and push in a certain direction, right? But it really does start with, you know, your honest intentions and your want to, you know, make your situation better and then bring people together, which then you take outside. So.
And it's often said that that great leaders have just had, you only need a minimum of one person to believe in you. And so just, you can be that one person for somebody else.
Well, that's fantastic. And that's an incredible note to end on too. Thank you so much. I really hope that all of our players can go out, you know, become leaders in our community and, you know, really find the power and find hopefully one person who believes in them and believe in themselves as well. So thank you so much.
Thank you. Thanks for inviting me to be on your first lecture. Thanks, Lauren.
Alrighty, San Bruno Junior Giants. Hopefully you enjoyed our first installment of Local Leaders, which was Leadership and Confidence with Councilmember Linda Mason. Can't wait to see you for our next installment of Local Leaders. Stay tuned for all the exciting segments to come, and I'll see you in practice.